What's up, YouTube? It's been a long time. Sean here. I go by Taylor Exchange on YouTube. I'm a part-time eBay reseller with hopes of doing this in the future full-time. Let me give you guys an update. It's the middle of March right now. I'm going to show you the accountability board. As you can see here, we have get free as the message to get free from full-time work. eBay listings for March 2021. We're sitting about 130 listings. In January, I hit 217 listings. In February, I was at about 186 because I ran out of inventory. But I'm not going to run out of inventory anymore because I've been buying. I've been going on out-of-town trips to Dallas and Oklahoma City. Those are the big cities around me. Check out what I got this last trip. I've got three bags here. Well, two IKEA bags and then a tub full of jeans and pants. I also have some snowboarding shoes or snowboarding boots, these Salomons. I paid $5 for these. Those Salomons go for about $100. I also picked up this, there's a lot of stuff in the garage. I picked up this Titleist. It's a TaylorMade R7 Limited. This is a driver. It's got these little adjustment screws. And I paid, less than $2 for that. I think it's like a $50 driver. Another thing I picked up, and this was at a pawn shop, I picked up this Magnavox. It's a combo unit right here. I paid $20 for this. It came with the remote. And they're comping on eBay for between $130 and like $160. If you do go to pawn shops, you're going to pay more for the item. But usually you'll have more of a return if it's working. And this one, I brought in a cassette tape and tested it in the store before I bought it. And I could hear it turning. I haven't hooked it up to the TV. But most likely if it spins back and forth and it comes out, there's a good chance that it's going to work. Another thing I picked up, now this was at a bookstore that had some electronics. It's a Logitech G13, I think. And this is like a gaming keyboard. You program the keys. They wanted $50 for it, but these are comping for between $100 and $120. So not a lot of money there, but the sell-through rate was extremely high. And that's something I always look for, because if the sell-through is high, you're going to flip your inventory quick. And that's what I'm all about. An update on the shelves. I have three shelving units here. So far, I have 40 boxes purchased from Uline. I'm following Chris at Daily Refinements Method because he seems like he's doing a good thing. And these are working out really well for me. The only thing I don't like about them is the top rack. Because I'm short, I'm only 5'9", I can't reach. Like, I can get on my toes and reach it, but I have to pull the whole box down. It's kind of a pain. So I have this black chair. It's covered in drywall mud because we used to use it when we were first renovating the house, because I don't even think we had any ladders or step stools in. So I just step up on this chair and I can reach the box and I can pull down and I can see, the inventory. And, these boxes may have like 20 items max in them. You have a bunch of shirts and stuff, you can really pack them in. At 20 items a pop or less, it's pretty easy to figure out like what I'm going for. And then if I'm deciding to list a few items, which I'm trying to list more items, like 10 plus a day is my goal. Whenever I go to list items, I look in the bins, and if I don't want to start like a new box, I'll look to see which one's almost empty. So like number 13, you can see there's only three shoes in here. There's some Sorel boots that are really nice. They're kind of a smaller size. And then a pair of Vans and some Brooks here. So if I had about 10 items to list, I would say, you know what? I'm going to just put 13 as the custom SKU, and I'm going to list all those items, and then I'm gonna bring them over here. So yeah, that's how things are going. Sourcing out of town in the bigger cities, I've noticed the buy cost for items is a lot higher. In Dallas, I averaged about $6 per item, and then this last trip, I think I averaged about $8. I haven't done the numbers exactly. I spent a little over $300, and then I spent about $100 between like the keypad and the Magnavox. I kind of count those items separate because they're kind of like, let's just try something here. But as far as like my common inventory, it's all these jeans. Now, whenever I look at jeans, if I'm spending $8, they need to sell for at least $30. Most of these I'll be able to list for $39.99 with free shipping. And at $8, like, that would be a pretty good profit if it's a full price sale. But I would take anything probably $25 or more, but I'm looking to hit that 30 mark. And a lot of times whenever I list a jean for $39.99, people will offer $35 or $30, and I have, best offer on there. So I kind of play with it. If the offer comes within the first month, sometimes I counter, but if it's at $35, I usually accept it. And that's how I'm trying to roll my inventory. I met up with another reseller It's Kaiser, who is Reseller on the Road on YouTube. It was great. He decided to come from Arkansas. He's about, I think, a few hours from Oklahoma City, and I'm a few hours from Oklahoma City. So we met there. He showed me like his he showed me like his 90-day numbers, and it's way higher than mine. And he actually has the same amount of sold as I do. So yeah, he's doing about five times what I'm doing, with probably divided by five, like five less. He has less items, let's just say that. But his average sell-through price is way high, and he does a lot of like pawn shops and different things like that. And it's a much harder game, you know. He has a lot more money tied into it, but his experience gives him the ability to go in there and identify really quickly. Like, we both went together, and he identified something for, I think he was out of the door at 170. I think he's going to get 500 in sales or something like that from that 170. It's something I need to kind of get better at, you know. I'm going to take these items into the room. I'm going to kind of show you how I separate them on my rack in the room and then get them ready for the listing process.
Hey guys, a quick update before I get into showing you the items. I wanted to share with you, one, the shirt color change. My sister-in-law is having a baby shower this afternoon, and I had the green shirt on earlier, but I decided to change to blue because I am thinking she's having a boy. And my wife said I had to change shirts. Also, I wanted to share with you guys, I thought it was about $8 average for buy cost on these items on the thrift trip, but it actually turns out to be $6.73 an item. So that's pretty nice. I typically roll around less than $5 here in town, but to pay up a little more for better quality items and a higher sale price, I'm willing to do that, and I'm pretty happy about it. So it was a total of 45 items, and that excludes the gaming keyboard and the, you know, fan that I got at the estate sale and the Magnavox combo unit. But the Magnavox and the Logitech keypad, that's probably going to be like the first two items to sell, because electronics seem to just have such a strong sell-through rate, especially in the time where people are, you know, it seems like they're on the computer more and playing games more so. All right, guys, I'll take you back to the video.
All right, so here are all the jeans, and I have this rack open, and I guess I could use this rack too. These are items that I bought before the trip to Oklahoma City. I found some vintage Christmas sweaters. I also found a cool fan that's in the thumbnail, and I can show you guys that in a minute. But first, I'm gonna go with these jeans, and I'm gonna separate them by men and women's and just put stacks here so that whenever I decide to list them, I can just pull them real quick and I can kind of get that process going. So I'm gonna speed it up, and we're gonna get this thing loaded on the rack. All right.
That pretty much concludes putting it all on the rack. And if you guys can see here, I have one stack of women's jeans, and then I have three stacks of men's jeans. Now, on my last trip to Dallas 2 weeks ago, it was even. I had two stacks of women's and two stacks of men's. I think I'm gonna make more money on these because men's jeans, if you buy the right ones, they seem to move pretty fast and for pretty good money. The women's are kind of like, you can call them bread and butter, but I was pretty much hitting higher average sale price on jeans in the out-of-town trip because the price to buy was much higher. In my town, jeans are $4.99, sometimes even $3.99. I can buy a jean that'll sell for $25 to $30 with relative ease. And sometimes I can even buy a jean for a dollar that'll sell for $20 to $25 here in town. But in these bigger cities, they don't really have like dollar price tags. I mean, sometimes they have half off sales, but I didn't see any where it was just like a straight up dollar for an item. So that's a little different. It was hard to like figure the numbers as I was going through the thrift stores, but the more I do it, the better I'm gonna get, and the better brands that I, you know, see on the internet or that I research through Terapeak or eBay, I'm gonna be able to have more confidence going into those stores. I did pick up three pairs of shoes that I showed you in the clip. Now, this New Balance, these are like the, they're kind of like orthopedic shoes. They're always like black and look like grandpa shoes. The ones with the hook and loop, they're gonna be better, you know? And then the ones with the lace, they'll go for a little less money, but these consistently go for like $50+. I also picked up the UGG Chukkas. Now the UGG Chukkas are a men's pair, which is great. And I've never even seen these. In my thrift stores, we don't have like, that have like high dollar stuff, you know, retail stores. So those are pretty new for me, but I think that's an easy $50. And then I picked up a pair of Brooks Levitate. I think these are like the OG Levitates. They have a little bit of wear on the right side. I think these are going for like $40. And the thrift store, I got those two shoes, the New Balance, the black ones, and the Levitates. Those were $4.99 for all shoes. So that was a pretty good pickup. And then the Uggs, I think, were like $10. Here's the fan that I wanted to talk to you guys about. It's not like super crazy. But I thought it was pretty cool to kind of put in the thumbnail because it's a little different. Now, this is an Emerson Jr. I picked up in an estate sale. I paid $40 for it. I think I paid it like the max I would pay for it. I would have liked to get out of there a lot cheaper, obviously. It does run. This has a little like switch right here that's broken off, but it's the dial to turn it off and on. Now, if you get the ones with the brass fans, that's gonna be worth like $300 to $400 to $500. This one, it's a 10-inch one, but it's just metal and it has painted, painted little fans. So this one's comping for, I think, between 100 and 160. I listed mine at $149.99, and I noted that I didn't paint anything on it or anything like that. But some people, they spray paint all of it, or they'll paint the fans gold again. I kind of like it sweaty, and I'm just gonna leave it at that. But this is a good example of an item that I'm paying more than like $10 for, and hoping to at least make my money back on it. You know, as far as I hope to make $40 spending $40 as far as profit goes. But it's pretty sweet. I turned it on and it's actually super powerful and I really like it. You guys let me know, are there any items that you see out there that you're willing to spend like a little more money for to flip it on eBay? I'm gonna kind of do a little couple more videos. I know I say that all the time, but it's hard to kind of get, you know, juiced up to make a video. But I hope you guys enjoyed me showing you what I picked up on the trip. Shout out to Kaiser, Reseller on the Road. Check out his channel. He's always finding good stuff and he's one of the, like, supreme resellers out there that a lot of people don't know about. But yeah, he's doing his thing and hopefully I can kind of get to his level and start you know, just making some more money. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy the content. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.